Hi viewers, welcome to Fire Engineering Lesson 1, Combustion Products and Hazards. Let us see the causes of fire growth. The fire growth inside a room are generally influenced by the room size, shape and construction of the room. Secondly, the quantity and type of material stored inside the room. Third, the room interiors finish, such as false ceiling, false floor, furniture upholstery, etc. And fourth, the air supply inside the room. Ventilation, how is it ventilated, such things. Next, we will see what happens during a fire. During a fire, the material stored inside that room undergo the process pyrolysis and combustion. So what is pyrolysis? Let's see what is pyrolysis. Most polymeric material, natural, synthetic, such as wood, polyurethane or nylon, can undergo pyrolysis and or combustion. So what is pyrolysis? It is a Greek word which means pyro means heat, lysis is breakdown. This reaction involves the breakdown of larger molecules into smaller molecules in the presence of heat. In other words, process of simultaneous phase change caused by heat. Next, we'll see what is combustion. Combustion is a chemical process of oxidation that occurs at a fast rate, fast enough to produce the temperature rise and usually light. So you can have a look at the fire triangle. The combination of fuel along with oxygen to produce the heat. So during a fire, there are generation of fire gases. The fire gases generation are depending upon the material which is in fire. The common gases are mentioned here: carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, hydrogen cyanide, nitrogen oxide, halogen acids, namely hydrogen fluoride, hydrogen chloride, hydrogen bromide. So we'll see the toxicity of fire gases and the exposure hazard to human. For CO, carbon monoxide, it is anemic hypoxia, which is inadequate supply of oxygen to the blood tissue, to the bloody tissue. HCN, hydrogen cyanide, lethal dose is approximately 25 times smaller than CO. That means this is very rapidly active toxicant. CO2, this is quite low in its own toxic potency. Due to combustion, O2 depletion may occur. When it is in the 21 to 17%, motor coordination may be impaired in human beings. 14 to 10% person may be conscious, but faulty judgment, fatigue risk. When it is 10 to 6%, person loses consciousness. Person must be revived with fresh air within few minutes. So these are the basic details of fire, combustion products and toxicity. Thanks for watching this video. We'll get back in lesson 2 with more details, basics of fire, fire science. Thank you.